Here's an example of a formula data reference. So this attribute called temperature difference, it has a data reference to a formula. So a formula is something that we're going to calculate within AF. We're going to store the calculation in AF, and it's going to look something like this. Here are my inputs, and here's my formula itself. And the units of measures have a role in this as well. So let's take a look at how we created this. I'll go ahead and delete this right now. And in this case, what we're doing is we want to find a temperature differential between the current temperature that we're measuring right there and the target temperature. So let's say our target temperature is 104. How close are we to that target temperature? And the calculation for that is going to be the absolute value of the target minus the current value. So that's our calculation. How will we go ahead and implement that? Well, first we'll create a new attribute, and then we'll specify a data reference to a formula. Now, there are a couple of givens here. First of all, we do have these two attributes, target temp and temperature. Both of them are configured with an assigned unit of measure. Now, that's not strictly necessary. You could have left all this blank, in which case you really give up the kind of the unit of measure conversion that we do support. Let's go ahead and create this new attribute. It's going to be called temp differential. Just call it that. So it's the difference between the input and, or the target, etc. For the unit of measure, this is important. We need to specify what units we're going to be working with here. And for this unit of measure, I'm going to go with a temperature measured in degrees centigrade as the other inputs are, the inputs to the calculation. So we'll go with temperature, degrees centigrade, or Celsius. And we'll talk more about this unit of measure in just a bit, but I'm going to go ahead and specify that. In this case, all of these are going to be using the same unit of measure. And for the data reference, we're going to specify formula. So by going into settings, this is where we can go ahead and build that formula. We're going to build it by assigning inputs over here, or parameters. And then generating the equation right here. So I'll specify my parameters by using this little button here to add the variable definitions. This is a really straightforward variable definition. We have just variables A through Z, and we specify which attribute is going to be which variable. In this case, we're going to start with the temperature, and we would always suggest, instead of using the default unit of measure, that you explicitly name a unit of measure. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the explicit degrees centigrade for that. And as you can see, this has been defined as both the attribute temperature and a specific unit. I'll add another one. This is going to be the target temperature. And again, I'm not leaving the default. I'm going to explicitly use this. Again, if you're not using units of measure, you can go ahead and leave the default, but I'm going to explicitly define that. Now, these are the, I guess what we would call our input parameters and the input parameter unit of measures. We also have a unit of measure we can assign to the result. So I'll do that as soon as I do my equation. Now, here's my equation. I'll go ahead and create this new equation. As you can see, we have a little formula builder here in which you can name variables and insert these variables, or you can just type them by hand. So for example, I'm going to take the target temperature minus the current temperature, and we have support for operators, adding the plus, the minus, etc. I'm going to do that, or I can just type it in here. And we do have some functions. One of the functions we support is the absolute function. Oops, where'd it go? And I'll go ahead and just modify this to make that function within or using the correct syntax for the function. So absolute. Now, again, I didn't need to use this little builder, but I can add that builder or use that builder if I want. You can test your calculation by choosing evaluate, and this is telling me the current difference is that. Now I'm going to explicitly define this as a result that is measured in degrees centigrade. We'll go ahead and evaluate. As you can see, now it's identified. It's explicitly set to the degrees centigrade. Now, why did we do these unit of measures? Well, as you're going to see later on, they can have a very important role if you're going to be paying attention and doing conversions. This essentially, on the input side, this is telling us how we want to treat the inputs On the result side, it's saying we're setting that result specifically to this unit of measure. Now, since we're doing, in this case, degrees Celsius all the way around, it's not so noticeable what the activity of the unit of measures is in this case. So there we go. Here's our result. As you can see, there's the temperature differential. If I go ahead and refresh this screen, it's going to ask me to save. And then refresh everything on here, we should see, yeah, there's our delta difference right there. So it's a 104 minus 39. That leaves us 64. I'd like to make a couple of points at this juncture here. First of all, if you take a look over here when you've selected our temperature differential, and take a look over here, you'll see that we describe briefly, or we have a summary there that shows us the inputs. Here's the temperature and its unit of measure. Here's the target temperature and its unit of measure. And then unit of measure is Celsius. And then here, this is the formula itself, and that's the unit of measure that we're outputting in. So you'll see that as just a kind of a shortcut, so you don't necessarily have to go in here and inspect everything by hand. You can just take a look at that. Also, I want to make the point that what we're storing here is the calculation. What we're not storing is the history. So this number here, as it changes, if I refresh this, this is a number that's going to change over time. It didn't really change there, but as I work with this, it's going to change as these values change. So we're not historizing this, but what we are doing is, of course, storing the calculation. And if you were to later change the query date so that you're looking at a different set of values for the inputs, of course, we will display the appropriate output in the formula there. So we don't store the history, but you should be able to expect to see the right calculation given whatever your current query date is.